It's race day at the University of Applied Sciences in Karlsruhe, Germany. Three international teams are participating in this competition, kind of online. That's not something that happens every day, especially not with this kind of vehicle.
Try to use it as a Draisine.
This is a Draisine, a bicycle without pedals. It was first constructed in Karlsruhe by inventor Karl von Reis over 200 years ago. Our three Draisines were built and designed by engineering students in Germany, Ethiopia and Malaysia. This race is one step of a project called Dreis 3D Trinational. It is a project financed by the Baden-Württemberg Stipendium for Students, BWS+, a scholarship program within the Baden-Württemberg Foundation. It runs over the course of 3 years with a sum of €140,000 and encourages innovative projects and international cooperation. For their project, the three teams had these objectives: build a stable Draisine, rideable for an adult, as lightweight as possible, using 3D printing, and using design elements from nature, so-called bionic design elements. Each team has a certain budget and about 3 months' time.
So the students have to design it firstly on paper, and then they have to transfer everything on the CAD, computer-aided design software. They've calculated that everything should work, everything should hold up the weight of the rider on the bike. So they transfer the design on a small SD card and then put it into the 3D printer, and the 3D printer should do the rest of the work.
It should be 3D printed, but it's also allowed to add other components, for example, to reinforce the, let's say, weak material which is used for 3D printing. So they also could use some stripes to take the tensile stress out of the design, something like that. Of course, also the wheels. But even so, one group also printed the wheels and even the tires. So they are free where they want to put the focus.
But the bike is not going to be printed as a whole. The students have to print smaller parts because our 3D printer is just about 200 millimeters by 200 millimeters. The printing size is limited of the 3D printer, but the bike itself, it's up to the students how big they want to do it.
If you give the students more or less freedom in how they design their product, then you have very creative solutions. Of course, not all solutions are maybe the optimum, but the experience they gain is much higher compared to a project where we give more strict regulations or even a manual. So yeah, we want to use the creativity of the students.
And I'm there to give some guidance on what is allowed, what's not okay, what can they improve on and stuff like that.
And so the work began. First, the tuition team had to make sure the students had roughly the same knowledge and skills about Draisines, the mechanics and 3D printing. So a week-long workshop was held. At the end of it, each team had built a small 3D printed bridge. The first challenge was completed. Now the real task began of designing and manufacturing a full-sized rideable vehicle. 3 months later, the three teams met online to present their finished vehicles and how they got there. Also, awards were handed out virtually after online polls. Whereas the team from University Malaysia Pahang, for example, won the award for the most bionic components used in the structure, the contenders from the Addis Ababa Institute of Technology faced incredible challenges during their 3D printing process, but came up with solutions and were awarded the Virtual Troubleshooting Prize. Then the races began. There were two challenges, a straight track for speed and a slalom course for maneuverability. The data was recorded and sent via a GPS tracking app. Even though the teams raced in different conditions and on different tracks, this technology made it possible to determine the winners. In the races, the team from HKA, that is Karlsruhe University of Applied Sciences, won. It was close, but the team in Germany won both tests after three riders gave it their best shot.
How is it? Exhausting, right?
Exhausting. It's really way more exhausting than I thought.
Yeah, I thought it was easy.
The third lap, it is really very exhausting.
Maybe it paid off to base their design on an existing one by an HKA mechatronics professor.
Yeah, it was exciting if the driver and the Draisine will survive or not, but they all survived.
and obviously had a lot of fun as well as gaining experience during the 3 months of the project.
They worked with passion on this topic. Even though the topic is a little bit bizarre for some of the students, yeah, they were really passionate to bring it forward, to find solutions, and they worked at night, at the weekends, and the dry scenes were finished last minute. Yeah, but then they finished and completed the mission.
As the money from the Baden-Württemberg Foundation comes in 3 batches for 3 years, there are 2 more years and 2 more projects to go.
And based on the experience, also from the organization side, we will now in the next weeks have some feedback talks also to the coordinators in Ethiopia and Malaysia. And then we will readjust for the next batch. The organization for the next batch, maybe also the task will be a little bit adjusted. Maybe in the next year or the year after, maybe we will also print a real bicycle with pedals. So it will be around the dry scene and bicycle, and also 3D printing, and also the design with bionic elements.